So bisphenol A is a pharmaceutical aerosol. So definition is that packaging of the therapeutic active ingredients in a pressurized system. Aerosols are depends on the power of compressed or liquefied gas to expel the contents from the container. So,
सर इसके अंदर गैस इसलिए होती है ताकि वो उसमें से एक्सपेल कर सके.
हाँ आगे चलते हैं, आगे आपको आज तक सुनते आगे आप पढ़ेंगे तो आपको मालूम हो जाएगा क्वांटिटीज. सो इट्स ए प्रेशराइज्ड, उसका उसका स्टिल हैव अनदर नेम ऑन द पावर ऑफ कंप्रेस्ड और लिक्विफाइड गैस टू एक्सपेल द कंटेंट्स फ्रॉम. जब आप जितना ये ओल्ड उसमें कम होती जाए गैस तो प्रेशर कम होता जाता है. ए टाइम विल कम जब वो बिल्कुल it cannot come out. Sometimes the drugs remain inside, but when the pressure nahi hai, it cannot. So it's a, on the power of compressed or liquefied gas to expel the content from containers. What's its advantage? A dose can be removed without contamination of material. Direct, you can take the dose. Otherwise, there are chances for other, in other dose forms, there are chances there may be contamination can happen. Contamination of material. A dose can be removed without contamination of material. Can be used. The medication can be delivered directly to the affected area in a desired form, such as spray, steam, quick breaking foam, or stable foam. How many forms? Spray, steams, quick breaking foam, or stable foam. Another irritation produced by the mechanical application of topical medication is reduced or eliminated. In certain cases, when you take that one's topical ointments or cream, there are chances of irritation. So in this case, irritation produced by the mechanical application of topical medication is reduced or eliminated. So if it is applied on topical, it's free from irritation over there. Fourth, ease of convenience of application. So just open that one and apply the dose. Otherwise, in case of other topicals, you have to take out the dose, then you have to rub over there. There's no need of rubbing over there. Application of medication in thin layer. So it formed a thin layer over the required surface. Now, what components? You can say it has one propellant container, valve and actuator, product concentrate. So the four things, product concentrate is over there, then valve and actuator you can see over in that shape over there, then that container, you most have seen the container when you used to take cold drink over there, they have certain type of container also. Then they have one propellant which has to take out. So it contains composition is propellant, container, valve and actuator, and product concentrate, the dose, the drug which is, the product concentrate is there, valve and actuator is there, container is there, and you can see in the picture there, dip, there is a dip tube is over there, liquefied gas, propellant is there. That propellant is a liquefied gas containing in that product concentrate. So dip tube is there, liquefied gas or propellant mixture is there. Further, what is the propellant? Propellant is a responsible for developing the power pressure within the container and also expel the product when the valve is open and in the atomization of foam production of the product. So it's responsible. So what the propellant has to generate the power pressure within the container and expel the product when the valve is opened and in the atomization of foam production of the product. For oral and inhalation, they can be used for oral and inhalation. So these are the propellant. One is fluorinated hydrocarbons. Fluorinated hydrocarbons. Second is difluoromethane. Second is difluoromethane is the propellant number 12. Then dichlorotetrafluoromethane. Dichloro tetrafluoromethane propanol 114. For topical preparations, these were for oral and inhalation. Mind it that these were for oral and inhalation. So for topical preparation, they are propane, butane, isobutane, compound gases, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide. So these are the various types of propellant which are used in pharmaceutical inhalers, pharmaceutical aerosols. So again, I repeat, for oral and inhalation, fluorinated hydrocarbons, difluoromethane, dichloro, tetrafluoromethane. For topical preparations, propane, butane, isobutane. Number compound gases, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, nitrous. These are used as a propellant in the pharmaceutical aerosols. Now, container types. They must withstand at pressure as high as 140 to 180 pounds per square inch. How much pressure? 140 to 180 per square pounds per square inch gauge at 13 degree F. A. Metals. Tin plated steel. The first is the metal tin plated steel. A side seam, 3 pieces, 2 pieces are drawn. C. Tin free steel. These are metals are used. Then aluminium, 2 piece. B is 1 piece extruded or drawn. So third, stainless steel, glass, uncoated glass, plastic coated glass. So the types, you can see that is metal is and aluminium and glass. These are various types of containers. Physicochemical properties of propellant, their vapor pressure, their boiling points and liquid density. They have the properties of propellant. They may have vapor pressure, they have boiling points, they have liquid density. Now valves, to deliver the drug in desired form, to give proper amount of medication, not differ from valve to valve of medication in pharmaceutical preparation. Now types of valves, continuous spray valve, high speed production technique, metering valves, dispersing of potent medication at proper dispersion, spray approximately 50 to 150 milligrams plus minus 10% of liquid materials at one time, use of same valve. Now valve components, ferrule or mount cap, valve body or housing, stem, gasket, spring, dip tube. So the valve components, ferrule or mount cap, then valve body or housing, stem, gasket, spring, dip tubes. Actuators, to ensure that aerosol product is delivered in proper and desired form. So different type of actuators is spray actuators, foam actuators, solid stream actuators, special actuators. Spray actuators, foam actuators, solid stream actuators, special actuators. So formulation of pharmaceutical aerosols, it contains two essential components. One is product concentrate, second is propellant. They must have product concentrate and propellant. Now product concentrate contains ingredients are mixture of active ingredients and others such as solvent, antioxidants and surfactants. Propellant may be single or blend of various propellants. Blend is a propellant used in a pharmaceutical formulation to achieve desired solubility, characteristics or various surfactants mixed to give the proper HLB value for emulsion systems to give the desired vapor pressure, solubility, and particle size. Parameters considerations: physical, chemical, and pharmaceutical properties of active ingredients vary according to site of applications. The types of system: solution system, water-based system, suspension or dispersion systems, foam system, aqueous stable foams, non-aqueous stable foams, quick breaking foam, thermal foams, intranasal aerosols. Manufacturing of pharmaceutical aerosols. Sorry, apparatus, pressure filling apparatus, cold filling apparatus. First is pressure filling apparatus, cold filling apparatus, compressed gas filling apparatus.